For today's video, I wanted to show you how I created this effect, which is modeled after this effect by Gibson Hazard. The effect itself is super simple, but there's a few little tweaks and adjustments you can make to change it and make it look a little bit better. The first thing you need to do is take all of the clips that you want to be in that zoom sequence and put them on the timeline back to back. And I'm gonna make them all 3 frames long, and we'll be coming back to that later, but for now, just make it 3 frames. It's also good to pick out clips that look similar, shots with similar subject matter, location, color, lighting, and this way it's just gonna look like more of a fluid motion through all of those clips. Now I'm gonna go to the first frame of my first clip and keyframe the scale at 100%. Then I'll move forward a couple frames to the end of that clip and set the scale to 200%. Now I'll just repeat that animation for the rest of the clips, and that's technically all that needs to be done to create this effect. But on this channel we have a quality standard, so we're gonna keep going and make it look even better. The way we're gonna do that is just by adding some motion blur. If you're in HitFilm or Final Cut Pro, then you can just drag a zoom blur effect onto your clips and you'll be done. But in Premiere, there's no built-in zoom blur effect. Shout out to Adobe for that one. There's a couple ways to fix this, but what I'm gonna do is just highlight all of those clips and replace them with an After Effects composition. Then once I'm in After Effects, I'll just enable motion blur for all of the separate clips as well as for the composition. Then just go back to Premiere Pro and you should have a finished, polished off effect. I mentioned earlier that I was making each clip 3 frames long, and you don't necessarily have to do it that way. You could make it 2 frames long and you're gonna have a really fast motion, or you could make it 4 frames long, or 5 or 6, and you're gonna have a slower motion the more frames that motion is stretched out over. And you absolutely don't have to animate it from 100 to 200% scale either. In my 2018 recap video, as well as my coastal vlog from this summer, I have sequences in those videos where I'm scaling the clips from 100 to 120% over about 10 frames. And it's just a much less dramatic, slower movement, but it helps to tie those shots together and make them really feel like a consistent sequence and a fluid motion. You could even switch it up within the same zoom sequence. In my 2018 video, I have a sequence where I stitched together a bunch of my Instagram photos and zoomed through them, and it starts out with each shot being 4 frames long, then goes to 3 frames, then 2 frames, and finally each one is just 1 frame long, and it's just a complete blur. Regardless of the values that you choose to use, I've found this to be a really cool and pretty easy way to make a sequence of clips really feel like one fluid motion. So I hope this helps you out, and it's something you can use in your videos in the future. So I hope you've learned something new from watching this. If you did, do feel free to show your support by leaving a like on the video, sharing it with your friends, or even subscribing to my channel. I upload 2 new filmmaking tutorials every single week. But that's all for now. Keep creating, and I'll see you in the next one.